Hey guys, do you remember the moment when you suddenly clearly realized what you wanted to do, or what profession is definitely yours? When children say that they want to become scientists, most often they think that they would be able to create some kind of mega cool stuff, acquire superpowers from the bites of radioactive spiders, or destroy enemies with some kind of laser beams. Unfortunately, this does not apply to all children. For example, the author of the book Genetics for Breakfast, Martin Motor, didn't grow up with such a clear idea, but he was always an inquisitive person. This first manifested when Martin, while still a child, was exploring his grandmother's strange equipment with his sister. And while one child was curiously examining the device, thrusting his finger into every hole, the other curiously twisted the handle on the side. As Martin wrote, "I remembered the construction of this device very well for all my life, and I still remember it very clearly, although I've never seen a meat grinder again." Martin prefers to recall this moment convincing himself that a sudden understanding of how the machine works eventually prompted his sister to become a physicist, but the sight of a finger from the inside instilled in him courage and desire to understand the human body, especially how to stop the wound. In a way, this incident was the impetus for Martin's interest in biology, and all the questions that could be asked rushed through his brain.
Is it possible to interbreed a mosquito with a firefly so that at night you can see where it's going to sting? And do caterpillars know that they will become butterflies? Or while building a cocoon, they wonder, what the hell am I doing?
Well, and many others. A few years later, well, with his fingertips long since recovering from his trauma, Motor enrolled in a biology course at the University of Vienna, intending to become a molecular biologist. Of course, he had no idea what to expect from it, since at that time the most persistent association with the topic of science in almost everyone were the night hours spent playing Half-Life. All the events unfolding in this computer game are seen through the eyes of a scientist who conducts an unsuccessful experiment, which results in the opening of an interdimensional portal. Then he has to grab a crowbar and begin to destroy the aliens who are trying to get through this portal.
All this seemed quite fascinating to me, but meanwhile I learned something that I couldn't even imagine at that time. Science in real life turned out to be even more exciting.
Sometimes scientists are accused of stealing magic because they are trying to understand and explain everything in the world. This accusation is as groundless as the mountain road in Siberia, if you try to drive on it on summer tires. There are two reasons for this. First of all, researchers are very happy that they don't understand everything. They work in a field that exists to generate new knowledge, and when there is nothing left to invent, waiting rooms in all employment offices will rapidly fill up with people in white lab coats. Second of all, when you understand something, that something doesn't become less attractive. A flower doesn't smell worse from the realization that the smell is used to lure the buzzing bees. On the contrary, knowledge of the general evolution of both beings only gives a new shade of beauty, just like the cheese in a cheeseburger. A research laboratory is like a toolbox that makes the imperceptible things of our world tangible, reveals hidden connections, and helps to discern the genius behind the seemingly common phenomena. Therefore, a person interested in science will see elegance even in the mold stains above the bathtub. Please meet this fungus, which, just like you, has overcome long billions of years of development. And be glad that evolution has sent you to a species that are able to hold a stain remover spray in their hands. All this is biology. Its molecular sister, genetics, deals with DNA, the blueprint of life. Strictly speaking, we differ from the African bullfrog only in our genes. Even though it's been only a little over 60 years since we had become familiar with DNA, today we are able to move and modify genes as if they were Lego bricks. So in this book, Genetics for Breakfast, Martin Motor, as well as genetics, biology and medicine, will give answers to important questions of life, such as, where do we come from? Can consciousness be cut with a knife? How much white bread does it take to get drunk? Do you have to tie the knot with someone? How to save a life with the smell of feet? And I'll be the one who brings those answers to you. It turns out that the more we comprehend the world, the more enormous it seems to us. In recent years, amazing discoveries have been made in science that have subjected our worldview and self-awareness to a serious test. Unfortunately, most of them hide in specialized magazines and hardly reach the attention of general public. Between the new episode of The Jerry Springer Show and the fifth repetition of an episode of Psychic Challenge. With this book, Martin and I would like to change this state of things. It tells about the most fascinating thoughts and ideas that a molecular biologist can think of. This book explores how genes, biology, and research affect our lives and will leave an even stronger imprint in the future. It covers topics from simple, well, human, such as love, to the mind of a digital worm that controls a Lego robot. But let's leave all this for the next time. I hope you are eager to find out about this. So, that's all for now. It was Brock from Broccoli Academy, and thanks for watching. Well, guys, do you want a part 2 or... I didn't hear a thing in part 1. Well, it's up to you to decide. If you make a great ratio of likes to views, and if you share and comment something like, yeah, go ahead, then I'll immediately proceed to the second part of Genetics for Breakfast. Otherwise, I'll do it anyway, but only being sad and unenthusiastic.